This administration is exercising fiscal discipline but advancing the agenda of growth in the economy.
This includes the development of key areas such as our ports, water, housing, and business processing outsourcing. Stay with us for the full update on these projects. Within the show, we'll also give you an update on the Caymanas Estate Conveyance Sewerage System and the benefits to further development of the area.
This transfer system is designed to address the entire development needs at full build-out.
Plus, the Jamaica Library Services Partnership Initiatives to provide the experience of a lifetime. I'm your host, Adrian Atkinson. Welcome to Jamaica Magazine.
Get legal advice for free. Yes, free, from the Mobile Justice Unit. The Mobile Justice Unit makes scheduled stops in towns across the country, and the unit is open for stops at community meetings and school expos. Get free consultation on matters to do with land, immigration, divorce, job redundancy or termination, custody and maintenance. The Mobile Justice Unit, providing access to timely justice outcomes. To request a visit, contact the Legal Aid Council, 131 Tower Street, downtown Kingston, or call them at 922-3761.
Good day, I'm Stephen McHugh, and this is your JIS News for Thursday, April 20. Government has allocated $300 million to help financially challenged tertiary students. The money will go to Jamaican students at the University of the West Indies, UWI, the University of Technology, and the Caribbean Maritime Institute. Minister of Education, Youth and Information, Senator Royal Reed, says the allocation to the UWI was conveyed at last week's meeting of the UWI Grants Committee at the Cave Hill campus in Barbados. The funds, which are coming from the ministry's budget, will be made available as at September 2017. Minister Reed says it is intended to help needy students and is not a means to pay the fees for all students who owe their universities. In the meantime, the Education Ministry is to set up a special task force to review the barring of financially delinquent final year students at the UWI Mona campus from sitting exams. This was agreed at a meeting held last night at Minister Reed's offices. The task force will also consider the UWI Guild of Students' appeal for more time to be granted to allow monthly paid persons and parents to settle fees by this month end. It was also agreed that a clear pathway to allow students to do their exams should be settled by next week, Monday. In addition to representatives from the ministry, the meeting was attended by members of the UWI Mona Principal's Office and Guild of Students, as well as representatives of the Students' Loan Bureau. $515 million will be made available for indigent housing, education expenses, and funeral grants starting this fiscal year. Minister of Local Government and Community Development Desmond McKenzie made the announcement during his sectoral presentation in Parliament yesterday. The allocation includes $115 million for a special fund to assist councillors' response to victims of fires. From the remaining $400 million, each municipal corporation will get $1.7 million to provide education grants to citizens. Individual local authorities will also receive $1.5 million for the provision of funeral grants, while $90 million is to care for those who live in indigent houses across the country. And each councillor will get access to $500,000 to provide needy constituents with housing assistance grants. Minister McKenzie says the processing of applications for all these benefits will be managed by the poor relief departments of the municipal corporations.
For many years, councillors have been able to do little more than comfort their constituents in the immediate aftermath of a disaster. This is why tangible changes are being made starting this year to give the elected councillors the financial tool to be effective.
Going forward, he says elected local representatives will be given money to assist with the operational expenses of an office in each division. And all councillors, along with the mayor of Portmore, will be given tablets to enhance their duties. Government's property tax collection target was exceeded by over $350 million in the last fiscal year. Local Government Minister Desmond McKenzie says a total of $7.61 billion was received for the period.
The reason why we were able to be so effective in the property tax collection, it was because of the two tax mobile that was introduced in the system, Mr. Speaker. And between the period of February to March, the tax mobile was able to collect $42.9 million of property taxes on the road, Mr. Speaker.
The minister says that based on last year's success, another property tax mobile unit will be acquired soon. A new regulatory authority is being established to replace the Government Electrical Inspectorate, GEI. Energy Minister Andrew Wheatley says the new entity, the Government Electrical Regulator, GER, will revamp the entire application, inspection, and licensing processes, making them more efficient.
The GER will be guided by the Electricity Act, and the related regulations that are currently being finalized will provide for the outsourcing of inspections and certification of premises to be electrified to suitable qualified persons from the private sector.
Minister Wheatley was making his contribution to the sectoral debate in Parliament on Tuesday. He said the new regulatory body was a partnership between government and the private sector to ensure national development. It will be responsible for regulating electrical inspections, licensing electricians and electrical inspectors, and monitoring work done by the electrical inspectors. And finally, the Curfew Home for Army Veterans at Cross Keys in Manchester has received a major facelift. The restoration was delivered through a partnership involving the National Housing Trust, the Jamaica Defense Force, and the Jamaica Legion. At Wednesday's handing over ceremony, Prime Minister Andrew Holness, who is also the Defense Minister, said the repairs were long overdue and served as an example of what can be achieved with all hands on deck.
For those who are housed at the Curfew Home, we owe them our freedom. We must practice kindness and we must lead by example. We must be each other's keeper. We must show how much we love our beloved country, Jamaica, by loving our neighbors and loving those who labored for us.
The Curfew Home houses 13 former Army men and women, most of whom are over 70 years old. And that's it for JIS News Today. I'm Stephen McHugh. Thanks for watching.
Productivity, pathway to prosperity. A message brought to you by the Jamaica Productivity Center, a department of the Ministry of Labor and Social Security.
Government is pursuing several projects within the new financial year, which will contribute to the country's development and growth agenda. Minister without portfolio in the Ministry of Economic Growth and Job Creation, Dr. Horace Chang, outlined some of those projects during his contribution to the sectoral debate. Here's a summary.
This administration is exercising fiscal discipline but advancing the agenda of growth in the economy.
And so, Minister without portfolio in the Ministry of Economic Growth and Job Creation, Dr. Horace Chang, has laid out a comprehensive plan of actions to advance key sectors of the economy. Among them, water, housing, port development, and business process outsourcing.
Water, for example, Mr. Speaker, water is life. It is essential for our survival. This government is therefore firmly committed to ensuring that our communities, our farmers and our industries have access to this precious commodity.
To guide that process is the soon-to-be-tabled revised water sector policy. Dr. Chang also announced plans to increase water supply to customers. Preparations are being made to set up a 15 million gallon per day treatment plant in St. Catherine to augment water supply to Portmore and the corporate area.
It is projected that the construction work will commence early 2018 or late this year possibly, and will provide a plant for up to 600 Jamaicans while providing additional water for the corporate area. The production capacity will be provided by this new water treatment plant will help to minimize the impact of drought. In fact, it will make us, as I said, drought resilient.
And in rural Jamaica, 11 projects covering 7 parishes and employing 250 persons are being undertaken through the Rural Water Supply Limited. For sewage, $12 million will be spent this year on projects under the Caribbean Regional Fund for Wastewater Management, CREW initiative. And to support farmers, the ministry has embarked on a program to repair irrigation canals. First up is the Essex Valley Agricultural Development Project in St. Elizabeth, followed by projects in Manchester, Clarendon, St. Catherine, and St. Thomas. A new structure aimed at reducing duplication in the housing sector will be implemented by year's end. To facilitate this, institutional reviews to ensure accountability and effectiveness have been done at the National Housing Trust, the Jamaica Mortgage Bank, and the Housing Agency of Jamaica. In addition, a national housing policy and implementation plan will be completed this year.
This policy will play a critical role in revitalizing and integrating the sector.
And to increase the housing stock, public-private partnerships have been sought to develop 580 acres with the possibility of providing 3,000 housing solutions. The lands are located in St. Anne, Trelawney, St. James, and St. Catherine. Informal settlements will also be addressed through a squatter upgrading program. And a Real Estate Authority of Jamaica will be formed with the merger of the Real Estate Board, the Commission of Strata Corporations, and the Registrar of Timeshare. Dredging of the access channel to the Kingston Harbour is 50% complete. Capacity upgrades at Gordon Quay to handle the largest ships coming through the Panama Canal is on the way. And new container equipment is being acquired.
On completion of the works in the first and second phases, capacity will move from 2.3 to 3.5 million TEUs.
Cruise shipping is also being targeted by the Ministry of Economic Growth and Job Creation. Initiatives are underway to improve the attractiveness and competitiveness of the ports at Montego Bay, Ocho Rios, and Falmouth.
The promotion of home porting will provide opportunities to develop spin-off projects. And the development of near-port logistics will generate high numbers of highly skilled jobs in both construction and long-term jobs.
And in support of that drive, more purpose-built facilities are being created to expand the business process outsourcing sector on the island.
Major developments in the BPO sector will lead to approximately 8,000 new jobs this year alone.
The ministry responsible for water, works, and housing is playing its part in advancing the growth agenda in Jamaica.
We will give people a real stake in their homes, in their communities, and in their country, as this is the only way that we can truly restore our not only prosperity, but the real Jamaican values.
Your children with their schoolwork. That means help. Don't do it for them. Every assignment, such as school-based assessments, SBAs, should be written and researched by the students. Doing the assignment is not helping your child, but rather teaching him or her to take shortcuts and even being dishonest.
SBAs are expected to be developmental. They are aligned to the syllabus, and it is really to assist the students in developing those fundamental concepts for them to do well in the examination itself.
Doing your child's assignment is a breach of the educational regulations, which carries severe sanctions. Be of help. Don't be dishonest.
The Jamaica Library Service, through its partners in the West Berlin Division, has been able to create an experience with a difference for those accessing its services in the parish. It has given library a new meaning.
A stone's throw from the Caribbean Sea is the Negril Branch Library. Picturesque, warm, tranquil, a haven for the community in this busy tourism mecca in Westmoreland. Bringing together children and adults alike, the library provides the place and space to fulfill educational and recreational needs. These services can be accessed throughout the entire Westmoreland Parish Library Network.
The Westmoreland Parish Library Network has 8 libraries, branch libraries, 1 major library, 1 mobile library service. We have 5 full-time libraries, 3 part-time libraries.
The Negril Branch Library has developed a strong network which has resulted in several partnerships which enhances the service capacity. Through partnership with the Rockhouse Foundation, the physical structure of the library has been transformed and crucial resources have been provided to strengthen its impact on the community.
We've expanded the library from what was originally 500 square feet in the front to a little less than 4,000 square feet. I think that it, it stands up to standards of a public library anywhere in the world. It's become an enticing physical environment. People like to be here. And that was, that was one of our objectives in creating the library so that it would be an enticing kind of place for both children and adults.
The Friends of the Library Committee is working to ensure that concerted and consistent steps are taken to promote the importance of the library service, primarily among the youth.
The objective is really just to make the library better, right? More efficient, more available to the kids in the neighborhood, to promote this idea that the library is a place where the kids can come, it's fun. Learning is fun. I'm inspired by Marcus Garvey, who says, intelligence rules the world. Ignorance carries its burden. This library is a testament to beating back ignorance.
In engaging its members and users, the library is cultivating an appreciation for technology through the Global Libraries ICT project.
The Westmoreland Parish Library Network received 60 computers from the Global Libraries ICT project. 2 laptops for the mobile library service. At the Negril Branch Library, we got 5 of those computers here. We use them for social media training, homework assistance, and a tech club.
The integration of technology is transforming the way how all users, young and old, interface with the various programs and services being offered at the library.
I am so proud to know at my age, at 72, I am doing computer. You can't tell how proud I am to be a part of the senior citizen computer class.
The children enjoy the tiny tot section where they come and they will select various books, especially interactive books. They enjoy, even though some of them might not be familiar with the words in the book, but the pictures are very bright and colorful, and so they will tend to look at the pictures and make up their own stories based on the characters they see in the story.
While building technological knowledge, there are other means to build the recreational needs of library members.
We also do performing arts. It is still one of the top activities that the library has to offer.
The Negril Branch Library's ongoing process of transformation and innovation ensures open access to information and lifelong learning.
Play is very important to the development of children. It allows them to use their creativity and develop their imagination. Through play, children interact with the world around them. They learn how to work in groups, share, and resolve conflicts.
They learn rules and they learn about respecting others and waiting turns and setting their own rules and guidelines for their game.
Set limits, but allow your children to play. It will help them develop the confidence and resilience needed to conquer future challenges.
We Jamaicans are a hard-working set of people, and we at the JIS know this. That's why after a hard day's work, you can simply pop onto our website, jis.gov.jm, and be in the know with government news and information. JIS, your information hub.
As part of the development strategy to attract investors, the Urban Development Corporation has facilitated the build-out of the Caymanas Estate Conveyance Sewerage System. The state-of-the-art system should be able to accommodate the entire development needs, and we have the details.
The Urban Development Corporation, in association with the Jamaica Information Service, presents Urban School.
The Caymanas Estate area has been a development area for the Urban Development Corporation, UDC, since 1986. The property spans the parishes of St. Andrew and St. Catherine, with at least 90% of its lands in St. Catherine. Measuring approximately 10,703 acres, the lands have functioned as a green belt to the thriving centers of Kingston and St. Andrew to the east, Portmore to the south, and Spanish Town to the west. Popular places in the area include the world-famous Caymanas Golf and Country Club. The Caymanas Estate area has seen changes over the years as the UDC continues to facilitate its development with the build-out of major infrastructure. Investments have included housing and road network connecting the north-south leg of Highway 2000. And more recently, the Urban Development Corporation has completed construction of the Caymanas Estate Conveyance Sewage System. This infrastructure has increased the opportunity for further development of the prime real estate property.
As you know, sewage disposal is one of the primary infrastructural needs for investment prospects. And this is now in place, so it's more attractive to developers as they come in, as UDC roll out its development plan for the area.
The conveyance sewage system forms part of the Caymanas Estate Development Plan, which outlines a broad built-out model for lands owned by the UDC and private interests. The development plan includes a mixed use of recreational, residential, and commercial buildings developed in harmony with the environment. The $624 million project was funded by the UDC from sale of assets. The scope of the project covers 7.4 kilometers of forced main pipeline and two lift stations. It also stretches across the Mandela Highway and connects to the Soapbury Wastewater Treatment Plant. Each lift station has an entrapment cage that intercepts debris in the line. These cages are then lifted and emptied to allow for smooth flow of the sewage. The plant is also outfitted with state-of-the-art technology systems and can accommodate a flow of over 200,000 gallons of sewage per day.
This transfer system is designed to address the entire development needs at full build-out.
And so to ensure smooth operations of the facility, testing was conducted on all pipelines by the chief engineer and his team.
It's a milestone for us because the plant is now ready to achieve what it was designed for. We achieved practical completion in November and we have commissioned the plant in December. We are at the stage now where we are about to turn on the system to transfer sewage from the development to the treatment plant in Sewerage.
The engineers and technical persons worked long and hard to accomplish this goal, but not without a few challenges.
The challenges are primarily engineering with respect to the water table. All the installation of the pipeline has been below the water table, so that was challenging in terms of the excavation and pipe installation.
With the sewage foundation now in place, Individual development in the Caymanas area will be able to expand and grow in accordance with the requisite permissions guided by the UDC's master plan for the area. The Urban Development Corporation, making development happen for you. To learn more about the work of the Urban Development Corporation, call 656-8031 or visit their website at udcja.com. You may also follow them on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and Instagram, or visit their information center on the ground floor, Kingston Mall, downtown Kingston.
Urban Scope was brought to you by the Urban Development Corporation in association with the Jamaica Information Service.
Respecting yourself, how you carry yourself, is very important. You hear me, young men? We take for granted oftentimes as men that people judge you before you even open your mouth. From the look at you, they form a perception. They make up their minds about you. So the question is, when they look at you, what do they see?
Children, a brighter tomorrow. Let's renew our pledge to God as we work to heal our land and fellow men.
Oh, oh, oh.
For righteousness.
Let's join hands
across Jamaica.
For righteousness.
That's how we bring the curtains down on our show for today. But if you want to see it again, log on to our website, jis.gov.jm. We always welcome your feedback, so keep sending your comments to Jamaica Magazine at jis.gov.jm or a tweet at JIS News. Our team will be back with another show tomorrow, same time, same station. On behalf of the entire production crew, I am Adrian Atkinson. Do take care.
This has been a production of the Jamaica Information Service, the voice of Jamaica.